Hello, everybody. Good morning. I'm meteorologist Adam McWilliams along with meteorologist Kara James, and we're going to give you a quick Hurricane Harvey update. Hurricane Harvey is a Category 2 hurricane. It's on the cusp of a Category 3. It's 110, which means that it has one more mile to go, and it will be a Category 3 hurricane, which is a major hurricane. Okay, so I'm going to turn the camera around and kind of give you what's going on right now with it, and then Kara's going to kind of give you the forecast of what's going to be going on over the next couple of days. So it's Harvey right now, and this is the satellite radar picture. There it is, a very well-defined hurricane, has a good eye on it, and it is moving to the northwest at around 10 miles an hour. In fact, we'll get a little bit closer for you so you can actually see what's going on. So there are the coordinates on it. Winds of 110, which makes it a Category 2, moving northwest at 10 miles an hour. The problem with Harvey is that it's running into an area of high pressure over Texas, and so that's going to act like a blocking mechanism, okay? So instead of letting this system move inland, it's going to move inland and then stop and meander around the area. So that's going to lead to some very impressive rainfall totals. We're talking 25 to 35 inches of rainfall. That's almost 3 feet of rain over the next several days. So that area of Texas is in for some very severe flooding conditions right now. And so just keep those people in your thoughts and prayers because this also will be coming in as a strengthening hurricane as well. So that's going to be another factor that is not good news for the Texas coast. Again, a Corpus Christi landfall right around, let's say 1 to 3 a.m. tomorrow morning is what we're thinking right now. Okay, so a little bit closer in, and you can see there's the path of it right there. It will be a Category 3 coming into the coast just south of Houston. This is the Corpus Christi area, and then it's just going to kind of meander around in here for a couple of days and dump all of that heavy rainfall across portions of Texas. All right, so here is the wind field on it, and the wind field, let me stop it. This is the current wind field right now, and you can see we have tropical storm force winds already approaching the coast right there. So from Brownsville to Corpus Christi, we already have tropical storm force winds. The orange shading are strong tropical storm force winds, and the red are hurricane force winds. Hurricane force winds are not going out very far from the center, maybe 25 miles from the center. Tropical storm force winds are going out 140 miles from the center.
Corpus Christi has had sustained winds at 35 miles an hour that we've seen so far, so that's good evidence that we are getting those wind values.
Okay, so we're about to show you radar here in just a minute, but thanks for pointing that out, Kara. So as we head over the next few hours, the storm is going to make landfall at Corpus Christi, we're thinking sometime tomorrow morning, and spreading those very damaging winds in as well. And Kara's going to handle the forecast. But around here, not much effect from Harvey, at least until maybe middle part of next week. We're going to see maybe some heavy rainfall developing. Of course, this is all contingent on what happens with Harvey, the track of it, and where it's going to be going. Mary Beth, yeah, the storm surge is going to be about 12 feet in that area where it makes landfall. So yeah, 12-foot storm surge. And that's the thing, you know, the winds don't really do a lot of the damage is the storm surge and the water. So that's going to be a big part. And the strengthening of the storm, we have water temperatures down there 85 degrees or higher. And so that's like perfect fuel for the for hurricanes down there, with this strengthening coming inland, it's not good news, not good news. Nadia, I hope I'm saying your name right, or Nadia, San Antonio, probably going to get some heavy rain too. I think, don't they have, we're checking the San Antonio area. I think it's a little bit, yeah. I believe, yes, San Antonio is under a tropical storm wind warning, so they're going to get some tropical storm winds actually in the San Antonio area. So if you have family or friends down there, let them know. Dorothy, Mississippi is not going to have the initial impact from Harvey. We're not going to get any of the hurricane conditions. We're going to get the indirect effects. When Harvey moves in, it's going to weaken, and what we're probably going to get from it is heavy rainfall from it. Louisiana, that would probably be the southwestern part of the state that would see the most impact from Hurricane Harvey. Dallas, probably not going to be much of an effect with the Dallas area. They're probably going to be get this through unscathed, probably. So not a whole lot of impact to Dallas. New Orleans, yeah, they could get some rainfall this weekend. It could be pretty heavy in some areas, and some coastal flooding because of a persistent easterly wind. We'll get the map back out here. And if you notice how hurricanes spin, it's counterclockwise. So New Orleans is getting that persistent east wind, which is going to pile up the water there in South Louisiana. Houston is not in the path, but they're getting some very heavy rainfall in Houston right now. They're actually on the worst side of it. They're in the northeast quadrant, which they get the heavy rain bands and the spin-up tornadoes. So that's the Houston area.
They're actually the first spin-up tornado warning that I've seen this morning just popped up a few minutes ago.
So. Okay, so tornado warning has just been issued just south of the Houston-Galveston area. Lubbock, well west of this. No threat to Lubbock, Texas. They're in the panhandle. There's no threat to that. High pressure's keeping that at bay. So Lubbock, no weather worries whatsoever. This is not going to be affecting Lubbock. Lubbock is way out here in the panhandle. No threat to Lubbock, Texas. Not sure where DeRidder, do you know where DeRidder, Louisiana is? But we're looking at that right now, where DeRidder would be. You can zoom out the map right there. Beauregard Parish. They could get some heavy rainfall in DeRidder, but no hurricane force winds or anything like that. Austin, heavy rainfall winds. Dallas, Irving, probably not going to get much effect from this hurricane, which is some good news. All right, so I'm going to turn this over to meteorologist Kara James, and she's going to give you kind of a forecast of what's going to be going on. So, Kara, take it away.
All right, guys. Well, Adam talked about the impacts in Texas and all the rain, and that's going to be the main problem for them there, and that'll be our main problem here as well. But we're going to go ahead and turn the camera around so you can see the graphics here too. And this is the big setup that we have right now with Harvey, which is kind of an interesting one because we have two high pressures kind of blocking Harvey, and the one out to the west here is definitely going to be the main one that's going to be impacting Harvey in terms of it just sitting right over Texas. That high pressure is a pretty strong one, and it's not going to be moving. And so that is going to lead to days and days and days of rain, very heavy rain for Texas, in addition to the storm surge, which we talked about, that could be as much as 12 feet in some places. So as Harvey very slowly skirts the coast here, it's going to be making landfall early, early in the morning. We're going to see it just kind of sit right along the coast there, and flooding is going to be the main concern for Texas and into parts of Louisiana, too, for the later part of the weekend. For us, you can see some showers here and there, but we're definitely not going to be seeing this kind of heavy rain from Harvey. That will be limited to Texas. But we're talking 15 to 25 inches of rain. Some places could get up to 3 feet of rain. So that is a lot of rain.
Right there.
Big problems. Big problems there. But for us, we should be just seeing scattered showers and storms. And then into the late part of the weekend, we may see, if Harvey starts to creep to the east a little bit, some of those showers moving in from Louisiana. But it's not going to be until probably midweek that we'll be seeing most of the effects that we'll get from Harvey, which will come in the form of heavy rain. But that all kind of depends on how quickly Harvey can get picked up out of Texas and move on out. And all indications do show that it's going to take a while for that to happen.
That's right, Kara, because you know, you've got high pressure, which is up here, and so that's basically stopping it from moving further inland, and so it's just going to kind of sit and meander. In fact, let me find the track real quick, and that's just going to kind of show you what we're talking about in terms of this thing kind of meandering. So this is the wind forecast, okay? So like you say, we're going to have landfall Saturday morning here near Corpus Christi, but look at what it does. It just kind of sits and meanders here along the Texas coast. And we're Monday, and this thing hasn't moved much. So we're talking about several days of just heavy rainfall there in South Texas. And mm-hmm. so that's going to be the big problem, is that this is going to really meander. And, of course, a lot of parallels are being drawn to Tropical Storm Allison that hit yep. in 2001 that just gave Houston so much flooding rains. Mm-hmm. And so that's the parallels that are being drawn now from Harvey, is that it's just going to be a prolific rain producer.
Yes, and there's a lot of very flat land just inland from the coast there, which is prone to flooding. And I used to live in Houston, and it used to flood a lot anyways, just with regular thunderstorms. So this is going to be a huge problem for the flooding in the urban areas, and then also on those flat lands, which drain into the urban areas as well.
Yeah, so that's the look at the current infrared right now. Again, a very good-looking storm, you know, as far as meteorologically, it's a very good-looking storm. In fact, let me pull up the satellite real quick. And if you notice, up here in Mississippi, we're getting some cloud cover indirectly related to Hurricane Harvey. And it's a very symmetrical storm. It's over
the eye right there,
and that is heading directly for Corpus Christi. In fact, mm-hmm. if you want to turn the camera around, Kara, this is Storm Shield 16-3D, and again, you can see that eye wall right there, and it's a very well-structured system.
Oh, yeah.
You can see the rain bands now coming on shore to Corpus Christi, and when we talk about the eye and those strong winds, this is where it is. This little yellow ring right here, that is the eye wall. And that is where those 110 mile an hour winds are. And so this is the core of the destructive wind. So if you drew a line, and of course, Harvey's been wobbling, you know, a little bit on its track. And strong hurricanes do that. They wobble a little bit on their track just due to them being so big and so strong. If you kind of extrapolate that out, so the core of the strong destructive winds will go right over the Corpus Christi area. So that's what we're expecting right now. If it continues on a northwest path, so Rockport and the Corpus Christi, Texas area, really under the gun right now, but very symmetrical storm. And again, it's going to be strengthening as it's making rainfall, which is the bad part. Okay, so this is a 2 right now. It's going to be going up to a Category 3 as it's making landfall. And of course, that's not going to be good news for the entire Texas coast, because you're just going to have hours and hours of persistent beach erosion, persistent onshore flow, which is going to lead to some coastal flooding. And the water temperatures out here, 85 degrees, so very warm water.
Yes.
So this is basically, you know, not a good situation.
No.
Major hurricane making landfall. And also, too, you have to look at the shape of the coastline.
Mm-hmm.
The shape of the coastline is kind of like a bowl, so it's going to kind of concentrate. But
all
they do have barrier islands out there, too, which may help a little bit.
Yeah, it's still going to be a problem.
It's still going to be a problem.
So you're pushing all of that water up, like you said, right into that bowl, and that's where those very large storm surge numbers are coming from, 6 to 9 feet, and there's a storm surge warning for much of the coastline there for obvious reasons.
Right. In fact, we'll put on the forecasted rain, and you can just see 10 to 20 inches.
And that may be conservative.
That may be conservative.
Yeah.
Some are forecasting upwards of 30 to 35 inches of rainfall, which I can't even fathom 35 inches of rain.
I can't either. And last year in Hurricane Matthew in South Carolina, we got about a foot of rain, and same thing with the flood the year before, and that was an insane amount of rain, and that's only a foot, you know,
two
feet is double that. And
almost 3 feet in probably in some areas, which is just incredible.
And there's just nowhere for the water to go at that point.
That's right. I mean, it can't go anywhere. And so it's just going to pile up. And so not a good situation panning out for the Texas Gulf Coast with this. For those of you joining us, we'll just do kind of a quick recap and end this video here. Just want to do a quick update for you guys. Hurricane Harvey is now a Category 2 hurricane. Winds are 110 miles an hour. It is 1 mile an hour away from becoming a major hurricane. Category 3 is 111 or higher. It is moving northwest at 10, and it will be making landfall sometime tomorrow morning, near Corpus Christi, Texas, and it is going to sit and meander over this area for several days and dump a lot of rainfall because of this blocking area of high pressure right here. That is going to basically block it from moving inland, so it's just going to sit and meander. All steering currents of this are going to collapse, basically, so this is just going to meander around. And then finally, as we head towards next week, we'll put on the map here, it might meander right here and then start to pull out across our area, so we could have some heavy rainfall developing later on next week. We're talking maybe Wednesday of next week. In fact, we'll put on the 7-day forecast and show you around here. We're looking at a pretty nice weekend, okay? So no effects from Harvey this weekend, but then as we head towards next week, that's what we're talking about with the rainfall right across our area, possibly Wednesday or Thursday. So definitely not good news for Texas to have that much rain over several days. We get any questions?
Going over the rain in the Jackson metro area, we just said that.
Yeah, the rain's not, we're not going to see any effects until maybe sometime next week here in Jackson. This is going to be a Texas storm for a while.
Yeah.
Yes. All right, guys. Well, thank you for joining us, and we'll turn the camera around so we can say bye to you guys. Bye. Thank you for joining us for the live video, and of course, we'll have much more on Harvey on the newscast later on tonight.